So I bought this cup online at the MoMA site, and I really like it. It reminds me of New York. It's ceramic. Happy to sell it to you.
Yeah, 20 bucks.
Clearly, I can't take your money through the webcam. That's why we need payment processing. Payment processing allows me to take money through credit cards online really easy. When we're choosing a payment processor, we want to consider ease of use, the amount of branding I can keep on my site, and likely the fees that we might have to pay along the way. Let's start with the easiest one possible. Gumroad, payment processing for everyone. When you come to Gumroad, you can sell an online class, a book, an album, anything. Shopify is another good example of being able to sell things today, super easy. But let's say you want to maintain some of your branding. This blue button will allow your customers to come and click and enter their credit card number and all that kind of stuff, make the payment, and then return right to the site. So they're always at your site. They're always seeing your branding, except for that pop-up. And finally, the most advanced of these three options is this example of the MoMA site. I come here and I don't know what payment processor they're using. It's just MoMA. And I can come and I can buy and I can add things to my cart. It's all seamlessly integrated. The way they did this is likely using something like Stripe's API. You'll need to know quite a bit of code to get this integrated, but you'll maintain all of your branding, it has the lowest fees, and it really just looks the best at the end of the day. So if you want to get started today, use something easy like Gumroad or Shopify. If you want the branding experience and you have some time and money, use the integrated Stripe API or something like the PayPal API.
Yo, let's mute this guy. I don't even want to hear him talk about his stupid cups.
Hey, what's going on right here, Chris?
Aw, look at you smashing cups.
Dude, you smashed that cup.